Konnichiwa, and welcome to Tsuki no Ame, where we try Japanese sweets and treats. Today we have two treats to try from Tokyo Treat, and we are again continuing the theme of very straightforward snacks. So to start with, we have a piece of strawberry teriyaki. Longtime viewers will probably remember that I adore teriyaki. For those new to the channel, dorayaki is basically two fluffy pancakes that are stuck together with a filling, usually based in bean paste of some type. Beans over in Japan are sweet, very, very sweet, extremely sweet. We've had some very, very good bean paste treats. This one, they actually do not specify what type of filling, just that it is strawberry. They are calling it tart. I'm hoping it's not that tart, but usually they're very good about balancing the sweetness of the anko beans with the pancake, making the pancakes only delicately sweet. So I'm hoping that that turns out pretty good. We've had excellent luck with dorayaki. I am excited. We are also doing our katana candy sword. So as it turns out, these are gumballs, apparently. So we are going to try these out. I am not 100% sure how we're going to break into the sword. I think I've got it figured out. We're going to find out if I actually do. I'm hoping I don't need to do a time jump in this. We're going to find out. So let's get started. Itadakimasu! Alright, starting with the teriyaki. Oh, I love when they send us teriyaki. It smells amazing. Some of the sweets that we get, it's possible to find online. You might have to do a little bit of digging to find them online, or some of these I've been able to find. Similar things kind of at my local Asian market. Mochi, as delicious and amazing as it is, and we do get the best mochi on the channel. I can often find something in town, but dorayaki I have searched for and I can hardly find anything. So I am super excited. Oh, and it is. There is a lot of filling in this. So right off the bat, like all the best teriyaki, these pancakes are so soft and so fluffy. I mean, they are the softest things to the touch. I can already feel how amazingly fluffy these things are. Oh. I love teriyaki so much. It's honestly one of my favorite foods. So the pancakes are so incredibly fluffy. They are perfect and tender and amazing. It is a bean paste filling, which I am super happy and excited about. The pancakes are very lightly sweet, which balances perfectly with how sweet the bean paste is. There is good, strong strawberry flavor. This is amazing. If you ever have the chance to try dorayaki, unless it is something, just if you have the chance to try dorayaki, try it. Just try it. It is so good. It is amazing. I love it. I really want to finish it right now, but I'm not going to. I will after I finish filming. Because, oh, as I yeah. It is very hard to go wrong with teriyaki. If you ever have the chance to, try it. So now we get to see if I can actually break into this thing, and I think I see like where a piece of tape ends. And then the tape just kind of fizzled out. In fairness to how tricky this thing is to get into, most of the packaging we've had has been really easy to get open. And I mean, like, incredibly so. It is really, most everything we've had has been very well designed. And that is the case I've found with a lot of Japanese products, is they're usually pretty good at designing their packaging for being easy to open. Trying not to take the label off, because our ninja guy here is kind of cool. I kind of want to leave him there. We've also got our shuriken. This thing is just fun. So, according to the guide, these are supposed to be somewhat citrusy. It's actually kind of nice. There's like this thing that they're getting stuck on, which helps keep all of them from pouring out when you have it open. So it does take a hot minute to get a piece out, but you know, it's not just going to go spilling everywhere. And it did reseal up to be the awesome sword again. Oh, I'm keeping this thing forever. So it does take a good long while for it to turn into a reasonable piece of gum. There's a good, a pretty decently thick candy coating on the outside of it, and it takes a lot to crunch through it. I didn't even get all of them fully crunched through. But it does eventually turn into a pretty decent piece of gum. It does have a nice citrusy flavor. It is tasty, but I'm going to just be very honest. This is one case where the packaging is 100% the reason to get this. And I think that's reason enough, personally. I am super happy with this thing. I think this thing is super cool and super fun, and getting to have it to kind of play around with. Oh, my cats stare at me going, what is our human doing? While I get to enjoy a piece of Toyaki, I think that's pretty awesome. So I'm going to recommend both of these. Gochisousama. So to recap, we did our strawberry Toyaki, which, as all Toyaki, the pancakes were super fluffy and soft and delicately sweet, balancing perfectly with the strawberry-flavored bean paste. So, so good. Highly recommend. We did our katana candy sword, which turned out to be kind of handy gum, and the gum is all right. It's not bad, but really, we buy the katana candy sword for the candy sword, and it is super super fun. I've had a really good time with all of this, and yeah. Thank you so much for joining me today and letting me play around with the sword and enjoy some Toyaki. If you like my shirt, the link for that is down in the description below. And please don't forget to like, comment, share, and subscribe. Janae!